The Federal Railroad Administration is imploring states to inspect stoplights at rail crossings. Many of them are not timed properly. Chris Van Cleve is looking into this.
Federal regulators say this shouldn't happen. A traffic light did not turn green long enough to give this semi-truck enough time to get off the tracks before the train approached. The driver survived, but many don't. Since 2013, 96 have died, another 419 were hurt at intersections where the stoplights are interconnected with the railroad equipment. Sarah Feinberg is the Federal Railroad Administrator.
But if the technology's there, why does it keep happening?
If the traffic signal's working the way that it should, if it's connected the right way to the railroad crossing equipment, we should be able to keep people off the track when a train is coming.
Tonight, the Federal Railroad Administration is issuing a safety advisory, asking states to inspect the traffic signals at roughly 5,000 interconnected railroad crossings nationwide.
It's really important to monitor these lights to make sure that the signals are not losing a second over time to make sure that traffic's moving through.
Whenever drivers are approaching railroad tracks, they just have to assume that a train is coming.
Dr. Lanny Wilson's 14-year-old daughter, Lauren, died when the car she was riding in was struck by a train.
It seemed like she had the world on a string, sitting on a rainbow, and we were there with her until that crash. And then, since then, we've done a lot to try to prevent this tragedy from happening to other families.
Regulators are also asking that event recorders be installed in these traffic signals to help determine if the signals are factoring into accidents. Scott, regulators are also working with tech companies like Google to share GPS data, so one day drivers will be warned as they're approaching train tracks.
Chris, thanks.